Have a good day.
Richard, you have a pretty interesting scene in Vengeance, which is your latest book. By the way, where do you want people to get the book?
They can get it anywhere. I get royalties no matter what happens.
Okay, good. Well, that's assured.
You know, it's if it's convenient. I will say that the publishing world is gone like everything else in reorganization of structure. And so, if you have a good independent store, bookstore that caters to you and knows you, go there, because they're struggling hard against the big chains and against the Amazon.com and all those things. Right.
God bless freedom. In Vengeance, you have this scene about an exercise where you do a night parachute drop into a truck depot at a National Guard base and rig the trailers with fake explosives. As part of that scene, you comment on the vulnerability of our nation's truck fleet. Could you briefly tell us how bad is that, and would armed truckers who are no-nonsense shooters make much of a difference?
Yeah, I mean, to answer that question, when we're very vulnerable, for those that, I guess, live here on the East Coast, you see the trucks on the road, but you don't see the magnitude of them at all the big warehouses in Indiana and Ohio and out west, where the truck farms, you take a good gander at them, and you're looking at 600, 800, 18-wheelers standing by just in some stage of get ready for transportation. And they're rolling all the time. And, it's easy to either hijack them, it's either modify them, and the truckers, I mean, they have to stay alert, one, just to stay alive, and they know what's going on, and they listen to talk shows while they're rolling.
Boy, do they ever.
I mean, God bless them. They are a set of eyes. That's another thing another thing I should have talked about when you raised the other issue of what we can do is that put them in on a flush network. We do have state control centers that have comms up. That when they're rolling, they can report things get scoffed in a hurry, and because they're up there reporting and they're jabbering night and day. I mean,
I'll do you one better. Have a computer system that when they give a control location, it activates cameras and sends the pictures of what they're seeing in real time right to Homeland Security. Wouldn't take that very much more work or network than we already have.
Yeah, we have the network. We just don't have the hardware, and
it's not wired together. It seems to me.
Yeah. Well, I would venture that there's a general counsel somewhere that says that Civil Liberties Union come down here and I'll be in court because that's another set of eyes spying on me. And of course, my view is if you're not doing anything wrong, what do you care what's going on?
Well, I could argue with you about that one, but I'm not going to in terms of this interview, because I want to ping your expertise, not tell you my opinions. I will tell you, I think you've missed the point in one type of truck. It's not been in any of your books, and that is a bull rack. Those trucks hauling cattle, no one would ever spot any kind of device, and no one is willing to go through the literal BS at the bottom of the truck to look for it. And it would be, those trucks don't have to be broken into. They have open slats on the sides. You could put some kind of a chemical weapon in there that would disperse as the thing went, and it wouldn't even take breaking into the truck to do it.
Yeah, they're already using those things in Iraq. They're bringing stuff in carcasses to penetrate.
Yeah, so, in animal carcasses.
Yeah, it's just a... unfortunately, Charles, it's just so easy being a bad guy.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't cost a lot. You just have to be aware, and where America doesn't fully understand the threat concept is when you look at suicide bombers. We go to war to preserve life, and none of us that go to war want to get killed. We want to kill the other guy. And now you're looking at an enemy that, one, doesn't like us, two, comes at us to die. I mean, that's like half the equation is gone. There certainly is no...
Now, how do you threaten somebody whose intent is to die?
Yeah, I mean...
As they come towards you, you have to hold up, like you said, the pigskin.
I mean, it's called, make my day. You kill them, you just made their day.
That's right.
And we just can't fathom that as a nation.
Respectfully, I hate to do this. I respectfully disagree with you. We can fathom it just fine. We know the phrase divine wind, right?
Yeah.
Well, these are the divine break winds. We're up, Richard. We're up on the next break.
You're listening to America Armed and Free on AM 690 KVOI, your high-velocity conduit to freedom,
with Charles Heller. Naval Special Warfare Group, Spec Ops CQB. Locking out of submarines, go in by SDV. Terminating terrorists, we're nothing but the best. Standing tall in our dress blues with tridents on our chest. Hoo-yah, we're Navy SEALs. Hoo-yah, fire in the hole. Hoo-yah, we'll never quit. Hoo-yah, we're good to go.
This is the Rogue Warrior, Dick Marcinko, reaching out to you in America, armed and free. 690 on your AM dial at KVOI, and Charles Heller's got the rest.
Hey, thanks, Richard. Really appreciate it. Again, I wanted to tell you that the music is from Tommy Cox, and he is a guy that does a lot of music about submarines, but he branched out a little bit and did a little bit about the SEALs. If you Google